Hey everyone, welcome to Premier Gal. In this video, you're going to learn everything you need to know about the new auto-ducking feature in Adobe Premiere Pro. Here in my Premiere Pro timeline, I have a working video edit of my NAB show video from Las Vegas, and it uses music from MusicBed. MusicBed is a music licensing company that is a high-quality resource for filmmakers. They have over 700 artists and composers to choose from, ranging from cinematic to hip-hop and indie rock. MusicBed has a brand new advanced search that will help you find the song you need fast. You can search by BPM, length, include or exclude parameters, and get suggested similar songs. Also, MusicBed just announced a new membership model, so for one set monthly fee, you can get unlimited music. More info coming in summer of 2018. For now, you can get 20% off your next license with my code PremiereGal20. All right, back to the tutorial. So you see here, I've started to build out my NAB show video edit. You can see I have two tracks of audio, a dialogue track on A1, and a music track from MusicBed on A2. If you do not see the waveforms like I do in the timeline, or this white center line here, which if you click and hold and move up or down adjusts the levels of the audio, simply go to the wrench tool and make sure to check on Show Audio Waveform and Show Audio Keyframes. You can also turn on the audio clip names so you can identify it through name as well in your timeline. So I'm not finished with this video yet, but let me play it back so you can hear how loud the music is against the dialogue as it plays. Hey everybody, it's Premier Gal here, and I'm here at the NAB show in Las Vegas. I'm going to pop inside the convention center, walk around. So you can hear the music is way too loud against the dialogue, so we need to change this using the Essential Sound panel. And with the new auto-ducking feature, you can tell Premiere Pro to duck or lower the audio at parts where people are speaking, which is so awesome. It will also auto-generate keyframes for you. So how exactly does this work? First, I'm going to lasso and select all the dialogue clips on A1. And then from the Essential Sound panel, I'm going to select dialogue as the audio type. Then select auto match to match the loudness of the dialogue to broadcast loudness standard. Even if you're not doing broadcast, just web video, I highly recommend still mixing for broadcast. Then select the music clip on A2 and select the music audio type, then select auto match to auto match it to broadcast loudness standard. Then check on the ducking from the ducking section. Now let me pull up the effects controls and watch what happens when you check and uncheck this ducking box on and off. You can see that it applies an amplify effect to the music clip. Next, you need to play around with the parameters inside of ducking. You can duck against multiple audio types: dialogue, music, sound effects, ambience, and even unassigned audio tracks. So then below that are three different parameters: sensitivity, reduced by, and fades. Sensitivity controls how much the Essential Sound panel can detect changes in the audio. So the lower the sensitivity, it is more difficult for Premiere to detect real changes in the audio as you would hear it. So I'll demo how this works more thoroughly in just a second, but for now, in our current scenario, I wouldn't recommend going below 5, and I'll show you why in a second. And reduced by is how much loudness you want the music to duck or reduce by when dialogue is heard. So I'll reduce by negative 13 decibels, typically between negative 13 to negative 18 decibels is good for dialogue, but it totally depends on how loud the dialogue sounds compared to the music. So then fade. Fade is how much of a bridge between the keyframes animating from low to high. So if you want it to be a quick fade from low loudness to high loudness, then you would lower the fade value to the left to be fast. And if you want it to be more gradual over time, you would increase that. So let's set ours to 700. Then let's hit generate keyframes. Now you will see in the timeline there are keyframes on the music track. And in the effects controls under amplify effect, you will also see the keyframes. Now let me give you a closer look at these controls. If I zoom into the timeline here on one of the fades, let me show you what happens when I increase the fade and hit generate again. Do you see how that fade just got longer? Now let me lower it to make it more fast. and you can see that there's much less of a fade. It's a quick transition. So that's a bit too quick in our case, so I'm going to move mine back up, let's say around 450. Now that looks good. Now with reduce by, let me show you what happens if I decrease this amount to negative 18. You will see that after you hit generate, that the audio line here drops down because it's dropping in loudness, and vice versa. If I turn it to negative 5 and hit generate keyframes, you can see that the line moves up. So let's move it back down to negative 13 again and hit generate. Now as for sensitivity, let me show you what happens when we move it to 3. Hit generate. And now in the timeline, you will see that there were added keyframes at spots that we don't want it to lower. You can see that as I zoom in, there's this extra keyframing section. So this is why I recommend increasing the sensitivity to high, so that way there's less of a chance of those accidental keyframes popping up in your music track. So every mix is different, so I would recommend playing around with sensitivity until you get it right, and then just continue to regenerate keyframes. All right, let's go ahead and play it back and see how it sounds. Hey everybody, it's Premier Gal here, and I'm here at the NAB show in Las Vegas. I'm going to pop inside the convention center, walk around, ask people to see how their show is going, as well as check out some of the latest video products. Let's go. What is NAB show in your own words?
100,000, it's crazy, I don't know.
NAB Show is like a Pinterest board of everything awesome to do with video.
It's great. It's great.
And I think it sounds pretty awesome. I can't wait to finish the edit and share it with you guys. Again, special thanks to MusicBed for sponsoring this video to help me create educational content for you. And don't forget, you can get 20% off your first music license with my code PremierGal20 at musicbed.com. If this video helped you out, be sure to give it a thumbs up, subscribe, and hit that notification bell so you're notified when I make new tutorials every week. Thanks again, you guys. Keep creating awesome content, and I'll see you all very soon.